We have seen that autophagy is a mechanism for self-digestion in our cells. Next, let's discuss the usefulness of self-digestion by autophagy to the cell. We currently know that autophagy has many important roles in life, but here we'll focus on three fundamental roles of autophagy. To explain the first of these, I'd like to use degradation of proteins as one example. Although autophagy degrades a wide range of molecules within cells. In this slide, we can see the daily flux of amino acids and proteins in a human body. We ingest about 70 grams of protein from food every day, which is digested into amino acids and delivered to cells throughout our bodies. However, this amount is far less than the amount of proteins produced in our bodies. About 200 grams of proteins are made every day from amino acids in our bodies. In addition, amino acids are also used for other purposes, such as the synthesis of non-protein molecules, and a subset of amino acids is excreted. This apparent shortfall in the flux of amino acids and proteins can be explained by protein degradation. In fact, about 200 grams of proteins in our bodies are degraded every day, and the resulting amino acids enter this flux. Autophagy is a major contributor to this degradation process. This means that our cells degrade as much protein as they synthesize. This may seem futile, but actually has a very important meaning. Continuous degradation and synthesis of several components prevent the accumulation of old components, which can be harmful to cells and accelerate the aging of cells and our bodies. In summary, autophagy plays an important role in keeping cellular components fresh. The second example of the important roles of autophagy is its function as a response to starvation. Here we'll consider protein degradation as an example. Organisms, especially those living in nature, often encounter starvation conditions. During these circumstances, the levels of amino acids decrease, which results in the attenuation of protein synthesis. Cells need to urgently adapt to these conditions. Autophagy is strongly induced in response to nutrient starvation and degrades existing proteins to produce amino acids, which are used for the synthesis of proteins required for adaptation to starvation, as well as the production of energy and other important molecules. In addition to proteins, other cellular components are also degraded and recycled by autophagy. Thus, autophagy plays an essential role for cells to survive nutrient starvation. Next, let's talk about the third example of the fundamental roles of autophagy. Within cells, harmful materials often arise. For instance, some proteins that have denatured and become abnormal due to stress or mutations can form aggregates, which are linked to neurodegeneration or liver disease. Dysfunctional mitochondria can produce a reactive oxygen species that can damage other parts of the cell, resulting in cellular aging and neurodegeneration. Moreover, in mammals, some bacteria and viruses invade cells and cause infectious diseases. Autophagy can eliminate large and harmful materials such as the example we just thought about. Autophagy therefore plays an important role in protecting us from cellular damage that results in aging and diseases. In addition to the three major roles we just considered, recent studies have revealed that autophagy is implicated in many physiological processes occurring within cells. Those shown here are a few of these processes. Evidence now indicates that autophagy is involved in intracellular clearance, anti-aging processes, starvation responses, organelle homeostasis, development and differentiation, and the presentation of antibodies. On the other hand, the failure of autophagy is suggested to be linked to a number of human diseases, including neurodegeneration, liver disease, heart failure, diabetes, microviral infection, and cancer. We'll discuss this topic more in week 3.